wanted to know more about this oddball mechanic. Surely he would find something somewhere on this land. Another instance of this magic ice. What was this one doing, lying on the ground, so afraid? The plot thickened like water into ice. A sudden cold snap struck Carl, who felt like he was pulled into a dream. He had been running in fear from something creeping towards him, against which he couldn't do anything, only to end up like this, petrified and cold. Thank you. It seemed as though Regin had been ready to take up arms and slay people like Hamilton. Could he have committed murder for his cause? Who could have gotten killed in front of his very eyes? Carl suddenly felt observed. He was worried about a presence around him. No stone can withstand the force of dynamite. Carl knew right away that the owner of this place wasn't a copper collector. No, this was a junkman's base of operations. The guy definitely seemed like quite the expert in scavenging scrap metal, with or without permission, surely. In the right hands, red metal could sell like hotcakes. Rock music invaded the minds of men even in the remotest of places. The man didn't own a turntable, though, so there's that going for him. Garbage trucks rarely made a stop in the area. Thankfully, the lake served as a pretty good backup dump for those times when the bins started overflowing. Thank you. last phantom, lost in solitude up until now. Join the others in the forest's darkness, free at last to enjoy an eternal, well-deserved slumber. Harl was only beginning to understand the horror which had struck his village. He understood that the dead were piling up and that he couldn't help them by himself. The road was clear for him. He needed to push further north and fast to find help. Another diary. Harl felt like someone was trying to communicate with him. Or was it simply the result of happenstance? Right until that point, Carl had believed that the object of this crossbow hunting had been a ravenous wolf who was terrorizing the village. But as he noticed the height at which the bolts had been fired, he concluded that the beast had to have been as tall as a man on his feet, not unlike a gorilla. The thought was chilling. Carl had found what he was looking for. He needed to get back on the road. Carl reckoned that the place was still inhabited less than 24 hours ago. His detective sense tingled, revealing to him, or was it the strong smell of wilderness in the air, that there were most likely two men. Two blankets, There were doubtless two people here, Carl reckoned. The jacket was still soaking wet. The poor man had, surely unwillingly, had a taste of the pond's water not too long ago. According to the pay stub, that poor man was Alexandre Blais. There should be a rifle hanging there. Its owner may not be very far. The door had been busted down violently, and a burnt smell filled the air. Half of the cabin had been consumed by flames. Carl surveyed the chaotic scene, noticing that someone appeared to have intended to use the furniture as bonfire fuel. Carl had no idea how such a mess could have occurred, but he knew it didn't bode well. Thank you. Two more victims of this ice plague. Carl felt a chill down his spine. What if he was next? Carl felt the strong pull of a vision overcome him. Like a simple hunting accident. There was Hamilton. Carl recognized him. A major hunting accident. The doctor examined the young woman. But death couldn't be overturned. She was dead. It was not the type of body you buried in a big ceremony in the village graveyard. It had to be hidden. No one could know about this. The best way to do that was to have a simple-minded man bury the poor girl, Lamotte, the mechanic. Doctor denied the unfair death of the young woman, but Hamilton had him in his grip. Hamilton knew all of the poet's secrets and wouldn't hesitate to reveal them. I know all about your crimes, you little communist. You know mine. What a sordid affair. Understood the ins and outs of the affair. A woman had been killed in an unfair accident, and a young warrior had damned himself to avenge her. But Hamilton, the one responsible, had already been killed, and so the beast could not quench its thirst for vengeance. And now, recklessly, Carl had pulled the bolt from the beast's heart. A beast who was but a young free man lost without his fiancée, and who had, out of hatred, become Wendigo. going under. His mouth tasted of death. Thank you. was going under. His mouth tasted of death.